السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. The second story of prioritizing the priority of the donor to your to the priority of your organization. We had financial constraint in 2018-2019 in Humanitarian Forum. And we had a donor who used to give us a fixed amount of money every year to help us running our affair. And all of a sudden they stopped, because they changed the board of management of this organization. And their answer came to us like a shock. What to do? We don't know what to do. They told me, go and visit your friend. I went to his house to meet him and his family. And I started to talk socializing with him after putting the points of discussion that I'm going to put it forward for them. First of all, I started with to ask about the health, the good health of his father and mother, because his father had a cancer and his mother had a stroke. And I linked their health with the hadith of the sadaqah and sadaqah, not zakah, actually, which mentioned by the Prophet ﷺ, and linked the sadaqah with curing the sick and dimming or removing the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and increase the length of the life of the individual. And he has to invest more in paying sadaqah besides what zakat they are giving every year. This was the first angle. The second angle, I mentioned to them the story of somebody from Egypt called engineer Salah Atiyah, who was from a small countryside village, and he came out from the military service and wanted to make a company for poultry company for chicken and chicken farm. And the asset, the capital of this company at the time was £2,000, and there were 9 people, and each one of them paid £200. And they told Salah Atiyah to go and find another investor. And they came after a few days in the meeting and told them, Alhamdulillah, I found the investor number 10. Said, who is he? Said, Allah. Allah will be number 10 for us. So 10% of our capital in our company, in our farm, goes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And astonishingly, in the first year, this company did not make a loss, in spite of the fact it deals with chicks and with chickens. And they made profit. So they increased the share of Allah, kept increasing it till the whole company become owned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and make a lot of projects in the countryside of Egypt. He was very excited to hear this story and said, from now on, for each asset, I'm going to take 10% for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I left them without asking them for anything, but he told me, I have some fund to give it to you to spend it privately on people that you want to give. After I left, I started thinking what to do, because I have a problem on my shoulder. I sent him a message telling him, thank you for giving me this bonus to spend, but unfortunately I cannot take it because I will give it to Humanitarian Forum, since your organization could not be able to meet our demand. They might have some financial constraint like us. That's why they did not give us the fund this year. He was very furious, and straight on, he called me on the telephone telling, what are you talking about? Why didn't you give you the fund? Send me the project, I'll give you the fund from my organization. I made sujood with my colleague and we send him the fund. But unfortunately, his organization registered to work only in UK, not abroad. The answer came back to me, a discussion with my colleague. They said, we can reshape the concept of the project proposal. I said, no way. No way to bargain with my relationship, our credibility and the integrity as individuals and as organization and as poor people. We have to respect our integrity, credibility, and keep saying the truth to them. And we told them we cannot take it because actually our organization is working internationally. I said, okay, fine, If this is the case, let me tell the lawyer to change the bylaw of the organization. And he did change it, and alhamdulillah, and send us the money. What did you benefit from this discussion? First of all, when you talk to a donor, talk to him about his benefit first and the benefit of his family before you talk about your benefit and your actually need. Second thing, be careful that actually to be trustworthy and honest, that you are not looking for his money or her money. You are looking for the credibility of your organization. Number three, respect your organization. Do not humiliate your organization. And do not humiliate the poor people that are actually standing for helping them. Number four, believe that the risk is in the hand of Allah, not in the hand of the donor. And we are, as human beings, are custodian of the fund that we have, if we are good slave of Allah. By doing this, for you will understand how to deal with any donor or with any organization or with any company can give you money. Jazakum Allah khair, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and they'll see you in another stop, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.